Good day to you all. In this video, I'm going to do experiments with diodes to ground and across them spark gap. Now, these experiments are based on a comment of Elisa group in a previous video of mine. And I'm really thankful that he brought these experiments on because I can really learn a lot of them. So in this experiment, I'm going to use high voltage. So therefore, you can only do these experiments if you know the dangers of high voltage and you do it at your own risk. I'm going only to show you some safety precautions that I have made and why I made them. But I'm not an expert at all. So please, if you experiment, do it at your own risk and do your research on the dangers of high voltage. So I have made two boxes because I realized when I did my first experiments that it was too dangerous to have wires lying around and so on the table. So one of the things I have made is this one. So it is a neon tube inside of a plastic tube. So it is well good isolated and I can feel around to see where the voltages are. Then I have my power supply over here in a box. And it's just a battery with on both terminals a neon bulb. And you will see that when the circuit is on later on that they will go on. So that's the reason why it is all boxed and isolated as much as possible. Because also on the low voltage side, we have that spikes that, and I experienced that by using this switch. So it was for switching the 12 volt, but I could feel the high voltage going through it. So that wasn't a good idea. And I want to prevent that I will not be able to switch off my power supply while I was doing some experimenting. So therefore I go to this system. So I made this connection over here that I can put in there. And then I have my circuit for powering it. And I only have to release it backwards. So also when there is something wrong, you always have the intensity to pull it back. So therefore the connection is not made by a switch, but with this type of connection. Of course, over here you can see there is also a switch in there as an extra safety precaution. Now these are not high voltage rated. So I'm going to look for longer ones so that when something happens that it's not will arc over too easily. Then I have the other box where my high voltage is in. And also in the background, you see this one. So this is to shortcut things out. So to discharge it. Now this is not suited to discharge a high capacitor value bank. This is just for this experiment because there is not much capacitor going on in this experiment over here. And I can discharge it this way. If you do this with a large capacity bank, you will not find your wire back again. So this is the high voltage circuit that we are now going to do the experiments with. So over here I have the ignition coil. Now I have to say I'm not using it like it is normally intended to do because it is as a spark gap for engines. So the voltage is coming much higher because I don't have that spark low that keeps the limit of the voltage at the lower level. So you will see arcing over here. But that is normal if you use tools that are not intended to. So over here I have an extra spark gap. And now there is nothing else connected. This wire is loose at the moment. This is for upcoming experiments afterwards. So this wire over here is going to a high voltage transformer on the high voltage side and then going to earth connection. Now in the first experiments, I'm going to connect earth directly to there if the earth connection is foreseen. But otherwise you will see that we can use this to light up an LED on this side over here. So it's a 12 volt 10 watt LED Now it has been abused too much. It won't light up fully anymore. The first experiment was much brighter, but this is not to show you over Unity or something. This is just to show you what happens when we change the setup of the diodes with, without, and the directions and earth connection and so on. At the low voltage side of this high voltage transformer, I have put a diode bridge or a rectifier bridge going to the capacitor and then to the LED. This is to show to myself and also now to you in the video that we can use that power indeed when we have that upload from Earth. So I'm going to leave the lid out of the deck of the box because otherwise it's not clear to show you the video. So I'm now going to put in the voltage, and you can see that we have the spark over there. But you don't see much spark over there. Now I'm going to discharge to see that everything is safe. Always do this before going into the box. Now I'm going to take my earth ground over here and connect it to that side. So at the moment, there is no diode between those, it's just a spark to earth ground. Going to put in the power. And now you can see that we have a spark. Okay, now I'm going to discharge it. Normally this just a small capacitor in the primary side to I think to get some kind of resonance with the coil because it's a series resonance thing, but it's normally in the primary, but I don't want to take any risks. So now we have seen the two. Now I'm going to remove the earth connection. So we didn't have a spark when there was no diode. So now I'm going to place the diode, and I'm going to place it in this direction. So I'm going to show you in the circuit. So in this direction, I'm now going to place it. So once again, I'm going to power up. And there is a very small spark. I don't know if you can see it on the camera. I'll try to zoom in. But you can see there's a very small spark now. I'm going to discharge. Okay. And now I'm going to connect earth ground to it again. Going to put in power. And you can see that nice bright spark. Now to have the comparison, and I will zoom back out. I leave the zoom like it is, but I'm going to disconnect it all again so that you can also have that zoom without the diodes, but with earth connection. So now the diodes are back out, as you can see over there. So now power up again. And you see we have that spark, but the diode gives a difference. The brightness is brighter when the diode is there. So going to discharge it again. Okay. Going to place the diodes again. Because that will give us the best result. And we can do it in both directions, or maybe I show it now. So I will put the diode in the other direction. So now we are looking at the diode in this direction. Going to power on. As you can see, we have that spark. Now I'm going to discharge it again and remove earth connection. So earth connection is away now. Going to power up. And you see very small spark, but not that much. Going to discharge. Now I'm going to add the high voltage transformer. So over there I have the ground connection externally. So now I am taking this high voltage transformer in the loop. So I'm going to the high voltage windings, from the high voltage winding other end to the earth ground, and then we have over here the secondary, which is now the 12 volts, or approximately, of course, because normally it is used with a 12 volt battery to create 15 kilovolts over here in the circuit that it is normally placed at. Over here we see the diode bridge and a capacitor, and then over here we are going to the LED. Now you must be careful, because also on the low side you will notice that when you place that neon tube across or against it, that it will light up. So also the high voltage peaks are available at this side. Now I think that is maybe because I'm too close to the whole system over here, and therefore for upcoming experiments I will build another box. Just like in the Don Smit, where we have separate modules, I will make his module every time in a box, so that is further away, and hopefully I don't get that high voltage spikes also on the secondary of the transformer and to the LED, because now I noticed that it is not that good anymore, the LED. So when I now power up, then you can see we have that spark and the LED is brightly on, slightly on, excuse me. Now it was much more brighter yesterday when I was doing experiments, the first thing, but as I mentioned, the LED is too much abused for the moment. But you can see that we can use the earth ground as a connection to upload energy to the system. So I will now discharge it and place the diodes in the other direction. That. Oh, also to the minus. Keep in mind also the two polarities. If you're not sure you have done it, then do it again without any doubt. Then you're very sure. So now I have connected back in this direction over here. Oh, I must also show you that the high voltage is on the neon tube on the battery. So we have that spark over there, and we can see that the LED is on. So doing it back off and back on. So again, this is not to show you over Unity or something else. This is just to show you what happens when we try out different connections. So if you look at the battery on in the box there, then you will see why I placed them there. So if I connect my power and it goes on, then you can see that the both neon are going on. Also, when we use this neon cube over here, and we go across that in close to the isolation over here, then you will see that it lights up. Now, in the video, it is not really shown because of the reflection of the tube, but I can promise you, if you do it in an experiment, you will see that it will light up. So I'm going to do much more experiments on this. This is just to show you my first results. I'm going to be sure that it is discharged before going further. Okay. So that is my setup that I am using. So it is clear that when we have that configuration of diodes that we have looked on the schematics over here, that we can have when the spark gap is over here, then we can get energy floating around, that the spark is created when we have the diode around, and it is better when the diode is there than when we are just using earth connection. That is one of the most important things. I will summarize the things over here in the video comment. It is based then on the also on the comment that ELISA group has given me. So thank you very much to ELISA group for these experiments, and for everyone who knows the dangers of high voltage, I would certainly say to try it out, but only if you know the dangers of the high voltage and do it at your own risk. I have tried it also with the plate. Maybe I can show you that one as a last experiment. So I'm going to take off the lid again. So it was discharged. So this wire is going to a plate approximately 1 meter 20 to 60 centimeters, and I'm going to connect that instead of the earth ground. So that wire is now connected. I'm going to switch on the power. As you can see, the LED also goes on. So we can use air grounding or earth grounding for this. But it is much better for yourself to experiment and to learn these things, not from a video, but only if you know the dangers of the high voltage. So thank you for watching, and hope to see you in the next movie. And please keep in mind, high voltage is dangerous.